Hi guys and welcome to this video. In this video we take a look at gauge optimization, or also size optimization, sort of. It's also a follow-up video to the last two videos where we took a look at shape optimizations with morphing and shape perturbation definition, and also free shape optimization, which is the last video. So this video, gauge size optimization. Let me show that on the whiteboard. So we had this cantilever beam, right? So we had a force fixed constraint here, and we had this shape perturbations where we defined a design variable to be a factor between 0 and 1 to apply this shape perturbation. Or in the free shape optimization, there you didn't define any shape perturbations, but just selected the nodes which are able to change. Now in this case, we are not doing a shape optimization, but you see the thickness. In here, the thickness was defined as a parameter like 1 millimeter in the property. You could also imagine that you could change this value in order to be compliant with this constraint, that a maximum of 3 millimeter displacement at this location is fulfilled, but a minimum volume is achieved. And how to do this? This is the scope of this video. So I'm back here in OptiStruct or HyperWorks 2020. And you see here that the optimization is the same as in the last thing. I didn't change anything here. So it is volume, which is minimized in the objective, like here, minimize volume. And we have a displacement, which is one node, which is the node here. And the displacement of this node should not be larger than 3. So upper bound 3. All right, now how to approach this sort of optimization. Let's see. In the optimization tab, you have this gauge optimization, which you can use. So you go here and the panel opens up and you have three radio buttons here. So create, update, and review. You want to be in the create menu here. And for example, we had, we had a property which has a thickness of 1 millimeter, and we know that the displacement is less than the constraint. All right, so we could decrease the thickness. And in this case, okay, our lower bound maybe is 0.3. Our upper bound is the 1 millimeter we have right now, or maybe even less, maybe 0.8. And the move limit is 0.1, which says that the solver is allowed to make change at a maximum of 0.1. We don't need it here right now, so we can leave that to default, because then the solver automatically adapts the rate of changing this parameter as it needs to. All right, now we can select in this selector a property which is affected, in this case our property p-shell. Select, and you see the type here, so it's p-shell t. The thickness is meant here to be affected by this design variable, and you don't really have to look into a separate dashboard for each property because we just have one property. Click on create and you will see the design variable has been created, which is here. So it's G P shell. What's that G? Maybe that's generic. Yeah, you see a generic relationship to P shell here. You have a relationship, which means this design variable is linked to a thickness of this property. So this is all that has been defined by this manner here. And that's about it. You can optimize it right away. So let's see, beam shape parameters. Yeah, that's okay. I will run the optimization right now. And I have the initial value is not upper bounds. Oh, let's see, something went wrong in the gauge definition. So I click it here. Here you don't have to be careful, because a click here just opens the panel. It doesn't create a gauge optimization. And now we can go into update and let's see. So we want to update GP shell and we made some mistake here. So we have to set the upper bound to 1 because the initial value is 1, and therefore we cannot define a property to be higher than the upper bound. So either we should change the p-shell to be 0.8, or we change the upper bound to 1, which in this case the later I have chosen to do. Click on update and start the optimization again. This time it should work. And now you can see, all right, it's just 3 iterations, and at the second iterations, you see that it already got to the final value. So you see there's a linear relationship, and the solver knows exactly where to go with the thickness. And you can look at the thickness and the results by clicking here. So shape-wise, it's pretty boring because it is the same shape as with the last, as with the original state, because we don't apply a shape change here. But look at the design variable here, element thickness. Here is 1, and going to 2, nothing changes. What? You have to apply the element thickness again, right? So apply here again, and now you can see, all right, 0.638. Now this is the result, and let's see if the constraint has been met displacement wise. Let's check the displacement. Originally 1.92 and optimized 3.013. well, that's okay. And now you can see what is the volume. So if you remember the latest 2 videos, so shape optimization got 766, 67, and the free shape optimization was better, it was 754. And now let's see where we are at the I'm getting confused, it's the parameter optimization or gauge optimization. So look into the output file, scroll down, and let's see. Well, we have even a lower optimization volume here, so 638 cubic millimeters. Well, that's pretty interesting, but maybe you cannot machine such a thickness, right? So maybe you can just buy plates with standardized thicknesses, and there's a way to take that into account in your optimization process as well. This is called discrete design variables. Discrete meaning that it is just having discrete values, so 0, 0.1, 0.2, and not something like 0.638. How to define it? Well, you saw in the gauge optimization panel that you had here a no DDVAL, which means no discrete design variable, but you can create something. Like here, if you change that, normally this is empty. If you click something, you see that you don't have any. So clicking on return. The most easy way, or the easiest way, is to go into the search panel and just click or type DDVAL, click enter. Now you are in this discrete design variable panel. You give it a name like my DD, like, yeah, let's stay consistent here, DVL. DDVL, right, okay. And now from 0 to 1, and here's the increment. So maybe 0.05. So you have the values 0, 0, 0.05, 0, 1, 0.15, and so on. Create it here, and now you can see it in the model browser here. You have a discrete design values variable. So variable is not really correct, it's values, discrete design values. And return here and go back to the gauge optimization, and now you can apply the discrete design values ID here, clicking once, selecting, and update it. Now let's see, the original optimization was at, now I clicked it away, that's not so good. Let's see, I want to see that. I know how to get there. If you have in the optimization, you can go into the out file. Let's just, for reference, copy that value, because I want to know how worse we are doing when using the discrete value. So here, iteration 2, this is where we're at. And I just copy that out here. 0.38, yeah, that's okay. Just copied it here. This is gauge 3. Alright, and gauge DD, well, 0. That's 0.5, this is the increment. And then we can compare the values. Alright, let's go back in here. I think we are set with here, and let's just use a different name here, DVL005, and run optdestruct. And now we should see a worse performance, right? So the maximum displacement is lower, which means there's more material. And I think we can go directly to the out file because, you know, shape change, it's not there. It's the same thing, but the volume is the thing which interests me the most. And here it's pretty obvious, so it's 650, right? So, yeah, because, yeah, the dimensions, if I had known them, that's something you can account for even by doing the calculations in your head. Right, so even if you choose to do a discrete design values study here with a plate thickness value, which you can buy, supposedly, you end up having a better value than going with the thickness, the original thickness of 1 millimeter and the shape design, as well as the shape, as well as the free shape. But what you have to take into account that this design occupies area-wise the same area as the original design. So it's no additional design space where you could put something in here. It's not there. But with the design, with the shape optimization, you have those. So as with the free size optimization, there is no way you can tell that shape optimization is always superior to gauge optimization, or gauge optimization is always superior than the other two. No, it's not like that. It's depending on your use case scenario, you have to apply the optimization technique needed to best achieve your goal. That's it, folks. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments, and I see you soon. Thanks for watching.